A friend of train driver John Kennedy says his death was entirely preventable. Professor Clive Williams has shared an email his mate sent in the weeks before the Wallen derailment, which included his concerns about the rail network. More from Reid Butler.
Picking up the pieces, but still no closer to answers, it's anger that's consuming John Kennedy's mate, Clive Williams.
I've lost a good friend and I feel very bitter about that.
He says Thursday's crash, which also killed the train's 49-year-old pilot, would never have happened if the tracks and trains had been properly maintained. This vision, supplied to Nine News, shows the rough ride and poor track conditions further up the line.
Look at that twist there, it's really severe.
It's certainly well below many railway systems in third world countries.
It's now clear Mr. Kennedy was concerned too. On February 3, the train driver sent Professor Williams an email. In it, he claimed five of his last six Melbourne return trips had been impacted by faults. On three of the runs, only one engine was operational, and on one trip, the train's speedometer wasn't working. Today, John Kennedy's sister Catherine told 2GB's Alan Jones of her grief.
I guess I just wanted to say that John, like, loved train driving. He's always wanted to be a train driver his whole life. And I know that I just can't believe that he would have taken unnecessary risks for people's lives.
Here at the site of the accident, the focus remains on clearing and repairing the tracks. It is a massive operation involving around 100 people, and it could take much of the week. The locomotive that wasn't damaged in the derailment hit the track and headed north to Sydney this morning, a carriage in tow. Two other carriages and the damaged locomotive will be transported by truck up the Hume Highway tomorrow. Reid Butler, Nine News.